Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by Debbie from Virginia. If you have a question for the Netcast, please feel free to send it in. I'll try and get to you on a future podcast. Debbie was actually in one of my Power Excel seminars, and I always show how to do subtotals there. She said she had a little bit different problem, though, so we added subtotals by account. Let's say data, subtotals, and say at every change in account, we want to add the sum function to profit, cost of goods sold, revenue, and quantity. Click OK. And of course, that adds subtotals in very, very quickly. Great way to quickly add subtotals. And as I show off in the Power Excel seminar, we have three new buttons over here, the group and outline buttons. And when we press the number 2 button, boy, we get just a great view of one line per customer. But in this unfortunate situation, we have the account numbers, and we really want to have the customer name. Is there a way to copy data down to all of the subtotal rows from, let's say, the row above? Well, there is a way to do it, and here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to select all of these cells here from the very first subtotal on row 6 down to the last subtotal on row 591. Now, normally, if I would enter a formula here, it would get entered in all of the cells. I really only want to enter this formula in the visible cells, the cells on the subtotal row. Fast way to do that is to hold down Alt and hit semicolon. That's the shortcut for Edit, Go to, Special, Visible Cells Only, OK. Now I've selected just those subtotal rows. I happen to be in cell E6. I basically want a formula here that says, give me the value from E5. So equal E5. But I want to enter that similar formula in every cell in the selection, so I'm going to use Ctrl+Enter. Ctrl+Enter, and very quickly, it takes the data from one row above and copies it down. Now you have to be very careful when you do this that you make sure to do that Alt semicolon. Otherwise, you're going to fill in all of the cells all the way down, and it becomes a disaster. But provided that you select the blanks and then Alt semicolon to select only those rows, equal, and then whatever cell is immediately above the active cell, Ctrl+Enter, we'll solve the problem. Thanks to Debbie for sending that question in. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.